Not just yet. So Pfizer's vaccine trial included people who were 16 years of age and older. The Moderna clinical trial included people who were 18 years of age and older. So if you're less than 18, you cannot get the Moderna vaccine, according to the FDA right now. And if you are less than 16, you cannot get the Pfizer vaccine as of right now. Now that could change as more studies come up. There's no reason to necessarily believe that these vaccines are not effective or problematic in children per se. But whether or not they truly benefit from them is always the question. And as we know, kids seem to tolerate this infection far better than adults. This is something that is a bit of a puzzle right now. We've had just a couple of these cases of severe allergic reactions to the Pfizer vaccine. They are few and far between, for sure. But it's not really clear what is in the vaccine that might be causing that in some of these patients. The ingredients in the vaccine appear to be relatively benign. If you are allergic to any ingredient in these vaccines, then you should not get the vaccine. And if you were one of these very, very rare people who actually had an anaphylactic response to the vaccine, then you should not get it again. But if you've had a history of allergic reactions, okay, so if you've had an allergic reaction to other vaccines or some other kind of injectable medicine, then that is not necessarily a concern for this vaccine. In other words, you are still okay to get this vaccine. Likewise, if you have a history of allergy to medications, pills, foods, like maybe a nut allergy, right, peanuts, etc., those kinds of things also do not preclude you from getting this vaccine. It's still considered safe. Now, we may ask you to hang around after you get the vaccine for observation, usually about 15 minutes. In some patients, it may be longer, but that's just to be extra safe. Reach out to your doctor to talk about them. The allergic reactions happen very quickly if they're going to happen at all, and that's why we keep folks around just for monitoring purposes, just to make sure that's not an issue. But the other symptoms, if you feel like you're experiencing those and you're worried about it, then by all means, contact your primary care provider to get some guidance on how to treat. The answer is yes, you are safe to get the vaccine. This vaccine does not contain a live virus in it. It does not contain the virus at all. And there is no reason to believe that it would be a risk or problematic in people who have problems with their immune system. They may not respond to the vaccine as well, right? So the efficacy of the vaccine may be diminished by virtue of their impaired immune systems, but they can still get the vaccine. And in fact, they should, because having the compromised immune system in the first place puts them at a higher risk of complications from COVID. A lot of women who are pregnant become very concerned about this for obvious reasons. You can't do a clinical trial with 40,000 people and not have some women in that trial get pregnant at some point during the study. And of course, that's what happened with these trials too. A couple dozen women do get pregnant and they seem to be fine. Both the American College of Obstetrics and Gynecology and the Society for Maternal Fetal Medicine have both endorsed this vaccine for pregnant women. And the FDA and both the CDC have said women who are pregnant can still choose to get this vaccine. So that's, they're not being excluded by any means. If I've had COVID, should I still get the vaccine? And the answer is yes, you should. Because again, we know that although after infection, people tend to have immunity to the virus, that immunity does not last forever. And over time, it can wane and reinfection is possible. So we know that one way to help would be to get the vaccine. Now, there's a couple caveats here. If you actually have COVID right now and you're under the weather, then no, you should not get the vaccine. If you've been treated for your COVID with either one of two things, either these monoclonal antibody therapies, which we occasionally use, or convalescent plasma infusions, which we occasionally use, then it is recommended you wait at least 90 days before getting the vaccine. Because in theory, those treatments could potentially interfere with the vaccine. There is no requirement for testing to get this vaccine, right? So if you're worried or you've had an exposure, then you don't need to get a test before you get this vaccine. If you had a very serious exposure or a very high risk exposure, like somebody at home came home with COVID, that would be considered high risk. Then we would say, why don't you wait, you know, after your exposure, the full 14-day quarantine period, and then get the vaccine. Make sure you don't develop symptoms in the meantime.